Asantewa. This is the town that Nanaya Asantewa in 1900, we all knew what happened between the British and the Ashantis. At that time, the British were in the helm of affairs, and the governor at that time, known as Governor Hudson, called for the head of the Ashantis having a golden stool, and the golden stool was given to them by the ancestors, and is full of gold and have a lot of keys around it. And they said any good thing on the land should go to the Queen of England. So they need the golden stool and have to go and give it to the Queen of England. And Ashanti said, we don't sit on the golden stool. It's something from our ancestors. So we cannot give it to you. On several occasions, Governor Hussein comes to Kumasi to demand the golden stool. 4 years after the deportation of Nana Prempeh, who was then the king of Ashanti, Governor Hudson came again and needed the golden stool. And as I said that, Nanaya Asantewa, because the strong men has been taken away, where did they take them to? They brought soldiers from Sierra Leone, from Gambia, from all British protected countries to fight the Ashantis and demand the golden stool. So Ashantis doesn't want to fight any more war. So what they did was that they carved a wood and sprayed it with bronze. And this was after they have captured Nanaya Asantewa. Nanaya Asantewa was very brave because all the strong men has been taken away by the British. Those who went to Elmina Castle, do you remember that when you went there during your tour, they told you that up on top of the castle, there's a building there that is said Nana Prempeh's room. Yes, and then Yaya Asantewa's room. There is an inland fort here. After they arrested the king, they took him there. They walked through the forest to Elmina Castle. Now, which was the slave dungeon, Elmina slave dungeons. And when they took him there, they built just a room on the top of the slave dungeon and kept them there. Ashanti's trek from here, when we were driving, how many hours? 3-4 hours. So if they are walking to Elmina, you can just imagine with their guns, to go and fight the British so that they can release their kings and their queen mothers. When the British saw that the Ashantis are very aggressive, what they did was that they had to pick them from there and send them to Sushil Island, where Nanaya Asantewa and few others died there. Nana Prempeh came back, and when he came back, he was a Christian. You will see his domi, God willing, tomorrow. Nanaya Asantewa was the queen mother who declared war on the British when they demanded for the golden stool. Traditionally, if you cross a gun in front of someone, you have declared a war. If you cross a knife in front of someone, you have declared a war. If you use your left hand to hit the backhand of someone, you have declared a war. So she declared a war and fought the British almost a year. The British brought soldiers from all West African protracted countries, and they could not locate where the Queen Mother is. She became the warlord, the war general, the commander of the soldiers. And she was there hiding somewhere and giving command. She has messengers that she sent message to. They go there and deliver the message to the soldiers, and they tell them, go here, attack this place, fight here, do this, do that. In I think 9 months to almost a year to the declaration of the war, one of her bodyguards was arrested by the British when he was going to deliver a message to a quarters of the soldiers. And when they arrested him, they took him to Accra, fed him very well, gave him a whole lot of things, and they tricked him. Tell us where the warlord is. The war general. The queen mother, where is she hiding? We will take you to see the queen, and the queen will dine with you if you tell us where the queen mother is. So this guy also, unknowing to him that he's being tricked, he also mentioned where the queen mother was hidden. So they attacked that area, and when the queen mother saw that the people had come to attack her, she ran away from that place with the golden stool. It got to a time that the queen mother had to delegate someone to take away the golden stool and hide it somewhere. You see, in the olden days, in the Bible, it was said that wherever Israelis go, they go with the ark, and the ark lead them to win a lot of war. When you sin against God and you don't ask for forgiveness, what happened? They lose the war. It's the same thing that happened with the golden stool. It's the same way. Legend has it that anytime that they are going for war, they go with the golden stool and they win their war. So the British wanted them to lose the war, so they don't want to take away the golden stool from them. They went and hid it. Immediately the person carried the golden stool left the queen mother Nanaya Santua to go and keep it somewhere. Per instructions of the queen mother Nanaya Santua, she was arrested. So they never had the golden stool. They never had the golden stool. Later on, when the British pressed so hard, what they did was that they carved a wood very nicely, spray it with bronze, and gave it to them as the golden stool. They also accepted it and took it. Years later, then they saw that they had been tricked. They thought they were wise, but the Ashantis made them so stupid. Later on, they brought the golden stool back to the Ashantis that it wasn't the golden stool, but it's a wood that you people spray it with bronze. And that bronze golden stool or whatsoever is still there that you can see right now. It's still there. So that is what the Yasantua did to help the Ashanti kingdom. As a result of that, in Ghana here, any woman, any lady, any girl who show a sign of bravery, that name is being given to that person, Yasantua. There are a lot of ladies who are very brave, and they call them, you are Yasantua. And the name, they assume the name Yasantua. Okay, so far is there